I woo! Woofing, woofing, woofing. What is woofing? Why should you do it? I'm about to tell you that soon, but you better watch this video. Don't go clicking away this video if you want to know about woofing. Roll the intro. Yo, what's up? Ah, baby. Boy of a shot. Back again. Whoa. Woo! Ah. So what is woofing? Simple concept. Skipping haircuts. Letting your hair grow. Pretty simple. Easy. Right? You got it. Good. Why should he do it? So woofing, you gotta woof for a purpose. The purpose of woofing is to make sure you make adjustments into your pattern. What I mean by adjustments, work on your definition. Work on your connections. Work on your depth. That's the definition. Depth. Remove forks. Maybe shift your pattern if you want to. But that's really the purpose of you woofing. Woofing is to make adjustments, make changes in your pattern to make it better. If you woofing, you still gotta do your brush work. You still gotta moisturize. You still gotta wash the style. You still gotta put the work in. You still gotta comb a lot too. You gotta put the work in. Just because you're woofing, that don't mean you stop working. No, that should be the time you do the most work, actually. Now, the rules of woofing. When you're woofing, you can still get your shape up, you still get your tapers, you still keep yourself looking clean. You can still woof, but still be ready to go out if you want to without cutting your hair, and you'll be fine. If you woof correctly, the only person that should know that you're woofing without you saying a word, is you. Depending on your hair or your wave texture, you have your limits of how long you can woof. You have your woof threshold, as I almost call it. Your woofing threshold. Somebody with tight curls, you probably woof for maybe 4 to 6 weeks. Somebody with more looser curls or medium curl tightness, you probably do 6 to 8 weeks. Or let's say 6 to 10 weeks. And if somebody with really loose curls, almost on the straighter side, y'all can woof for like a year if you want to. I barely even got curls, so y'all better be woofing. Shoot. Now, there's this thing called overwoofing. Overwoofing happens when your waves start to overcurl. It gets very hard to lay your waves down without excess pomade. Signs that you're overwoofing is overcurling. Your hard brush starts to feel pretty soft. It starts to lose its firmness. That's when you know you need a haircut. You need a haircut ASAP. Now, I know you see these woof challenges of guys going 4 months, 6 months, a year, 9 months, 2 years. I'm gonna keep it real. That's unnecessary. You don't need to do none of that. You don't need all that. Them guys doing all that extra woofing all those months, they're trying to break the Guinness Book of World Records doing that. They're doing that because they're trying to do a challenge. That's what's called a challenge. But a normal person, remember your woof threshold. You get a haircut at least once a month. Minimum, once a month you get a haircut. If you want to skip that month haircut and get one every 2 months, that's fine too. But don't be waiting on 9 months or 2 years to get a haircut. That's a little excessive right there. You all need extra products. And you're going to be wasting these products. You spend money on these products, you don't even want to waste them. Because you want to do a Guinness Book of World Records challenge. Woo! Let me know how that woof sound was in the comments. Reading the concept of woofing, why you do it, how not to overwoof, and how to not do the necessary woof challenges. I'm not knocking the guys that are doing those long woofs. If you want to do that, that's cool. That's fine. No problems. Let me add this too. Best time of the year to woof is when it's cold. Okay, you know, within the summertime, it's gonna be a headache. Got frizz, it's gonna be a challenge. Remember, heat is undefeated. But on that note, that being said, like, comment, subscribe, share with your peoples, and I'm gonna see you next video.